Yehi Ratzon, Pesach 5779. Yehi Ratzon the limud should be the refuat kol acholim. Uvetocham Tanya batoda Magalit, Yosef Yair ben Aviva Chava, Harav Sivan ben Sima, betoch kol shar chole Yisrael. Baruch Hashem, we've spoken a lot, learned a lot about Pesach, and we get to the big night, and we're going to be at the Seders. And so I just wanted to finish with one last question, and the last question is to try and understand why the name of Pesach is Pesach. The Sfarim in the year 1871, he teaches this idea that Shem HaChag Mole Al Ikar HaChag, meaning that the name chosen for each Chag is emphasizing the main idea of each of the holidays. And so on a basic level, the most simple idea of Pesach is that Hashem himself passed over the homes of the Jewish people and the Bechorim were saved, right? The firstborns were saved. But the question to try and understand this is, why is this the core of the holiday? Why is it the core of the holiday that we emphasize that Hashem passed over the homes of the Jewish people? There were a lot of other things that we could have called the holiday, could have called it Korban, we could have called it Kirva, we could have called it Geula. There are a lot of different things that happened, and we emphasize specifically that Hashem jumped over the homes. And so the question, you know, that the Sfarim is asking is, why is this the action that we're focusing on? Why is this the main thing that we're trying to speak about and recognize as the center of Pesach? And in order to answer that question, I think it's important to look in the Jewish calendar and ask ourselves, when do we find the appearance of the number 8? And I'll explain in a second what I mean. But throughout our calendar, we find very often this idea of 7 days preparing for the 8th day. So the easiest example is the Yom HaShmini. We have 7 days of Yemei Miluim, 7 days that the Jewish people are preparing the Mishkan. And on the 8th day, they wait for Hashem to come down. And so if we... There, Adi's is here just to say hi. Wants to know if this is kasher lePesach. And the answer is, it is not kasher for Pesach.
Because I eat
it
in Roni's room.
No, not in Roni's room. Bezat Hashem. So if we look back into Shivat Yemei Miluim, the idea of the 7 days is preparation. And on the 8th day, we receive a reward. And we can see the same thing with Sfirat HaOmer. We count 7 times 7. We do everything we can, all the preparations, all the work. And on the 50th day, which is equivalent to the 8th day, Hashem comes down and gives us the Torah. Similar to the Brit Milah, for 7 days, the child has to prepare himself for the 8th day, which is the Brit Milah. In Tumah V'Taharah, we know that there's 7 days of purifying, of counting. And on the 8th day is when you receive again the present from Hashem to be Tahor. And so there's always this concept, and we could see it also in Sukkot, 7 days of the Sukkah, to prepare you for Shmini Atzeret. For the 8th day, we will receive like the eternal love from Hashem. And so the concept of 7 and then 8 is that we're always recognizing that our job is to prepare. And once we've prepared, then we can get a present. Then we could get an amazing revelation from Hashem. There's only one time where the structure is not preparation and then being given a present, rather first being given a present and then 7 days. And where is that found? In Pesach. We know that Pesach, the Korban Pesach, is on Yudalid Nisan, which means that the redemption was given to us on that day. The idea of the redemption, that was given to us. And then we have the 7 days of Pesach. Meaning the difference in Pesach is that first Hashem gives to us, and then we build off of that 7 days of Pesach. But it's saying that there's something so different about Pesach, that if in every other time you need to earn the present, on Pesach you're given the present davka when you don't earn it. You're given to it to recognize and realize that the only ability you'll have to work on the relationship with Hashem is if you realize that it started off from Hashem and not from you. Because we so much, especially in the I would guess in a generation that returned back to Eretz Yisrael and has come back and is building and is fighting. We're very, very focused on we have to earn our accomplishments and we have to work. And it's all true. But you can only do that if you realize that first you were given an eternal love that has nothing to do with who you are and what you do. And we know that there's a great minhag, and Rav Kook would be very, very makpid on it, to read Shir HaShirim at the end of the Haggadah. And why do we read Shir HaShirim? Because the eternal love. And there's another minhag that we don't say, Shema or Halacha, that we don't say Shema when we go to sleep, because it's Leil Ashmoret. It's a Leil that we're protected. What does it mean that Leil we're protected? The idea of Pesach is to realize that Hashem chose you before you chose Him. It's to realize that Hashem chose you internally, and it's undefined, and there is nothing that can ever break it or destroy it. And on this we can build forever. And so I think that to go back to the question of why Pesach, because the idea of Pesach is that Hashem did something that we did not earn, that we didn't build for and we didn't prepare for. We were not ready for Yetziat Mitzrayim. And it's obviously proof after that we're so scared when we leave Mitzrayim, we weren't ready for it and we didn't earn it. But that's why Pesach is so important. It's to realize different than in any other time, like we say in the Haggadah, that V'yotzi'enu Hashem b'Mitzrayim lo al yedei malach v'lo al yedei saraf v'lo al yedei shaliach ela Hashem b'chvodo v'atzmo. The idea is to realize that the relationship with Hashem starts from understanding that He believes in you more than you believe in yourself. And so my bracha as we get into our Sedarim and we sit throughout the night of the Seder is that we realize that the things that we have been given from Hashem is sometimes to show us not what we earned, but how much Hashem gave us and instilled in us to show us that we can do so much more than we ever accomplished, than we ever imagined. And that's real redemption. That you don't minimize your ability. Your ability is not defined by what you have done, but it's defined by the fact that something eternal chose you. And so therefore you're eternal. And if you're eternal,